the systems that I saw were in Germany and in Holland, where they a complete phase out of barren battery cages this coming year. And the European Union has seen fit to allow colony cages. The interesting part about that is that they're now looking in the European Union to phasing out the colony cages as well. And this is really right on the heels of the barren battery cage. And part of the reason for that is economic, because actually a caged bird egg is a caged bird egg and must be shown as such. They're actually stamped on the eggs in the European Union. And so you can't get past the fact that this is a bird, this is a caged bird egg. The cages that I saw were actually smaller than the cages that we are looking at in New Zealand. They had 20 birds, a maximum of 20 birds per cage, and a scratch pad and a small quasi area at the end for nesting. The trouble is that birds are highly competitive. They don't call it a pecking order for nothing. And so there will be birds within that cage that never get into that nesting area. The important part about it was, first of all, there were not 20 birds per cage. Now, we have no way of going into these buildings, as has been shown. And my understanding was, because I counted 22, 23 birds in each cage, dead birds hanging out of cages. And this is on a good farm where we're being shown examples of rearing systems. So dead birds and concentration camp actually, I mean, you get into trouble when you start making that that analogy, but it has to be said that there were scrawny necks sticking out of the cages, and as I said, I counted 22, 23 in each cage. And when I asked about that, they said, well, the hatcheries gave them more because of mortalities. Clearly they hadn't had a lot of mortalities because every cage I counted had more than 20 birds in it, and that meant that any small advantage that these colony cages had was actually taken up. The other disturbing part about that is, I mean, there is a whole disturbing part about caged birds anyway, in that they are largely reared in barns, and then at 16 or 14 weeks of age, they're stuck into a cage. So they know all of the behaviours, the preening and the dust bathing and the perching they've been able to do when they've been reared, then they're stuck in a cage. So it's not like being blind at birth, it's like going blind, because they can't do those things within a cage. They can't even raise themselves up 60 centimetres as a good height for any sort of cage for birds, for layer hens. So they can't do that. The perches aren't high enough to make them feel safe, because they perch to make themselves feel safe at night. So, and in the cages that I saw, the scratch pad, seriously, it was a piece of AstroTurf that big. Now, move over, Martha, it's my turn to scratch. You know, who's going to get on that except by accident? So it was just a joke. I couldn't see that there was any advantage to these birds. And the other part about it was that the lights were so low, they had this red light within the shed. I had to use full flash for my camera taking photographs. And I asked them about that, and they said that was to stop pecking. Well, actually, when you looked at the birds, it didn't stop anything, because they were basically no feathers, because there's nothing else for them to do. You know, we've got an opportunity in New Zealand. Figures that we've been given between the difference between cages, the colony cages and the battery cages, show that it's going to be more expensive to put the colony cages in, and we have to reach overseas to have a look at how much it costs to put in a perchery or a barn. What they've shown overseas is that actually the cost to put in a perchery is less, and that's based on good stocking standards. If you go to slightly more stocking standards, even the running or the production of the eggs within a perchery comes into line with the running in enriched cages. We've got an opportunity to go to a system which is much more humane for animals. MAF did a very extensive piece of research earlier this year. It's available on their websites, and it's called What New Zealanders Really Think About Animal Welfare, March 2011, so it's very current. It was a wide survey, over 1,000 people were surveyed, and of them, when they were asked the question, farm animals whose current level of welfare and protection should be most improved, 75% said that that was battery hens and eggs for egg production. So this country believes we should have better welfare. Having seen these colony cages, albeit the ones overseas, I don't believe that you've got a system that is in any way transparent. And basically, in the end, a cage is a cage. We can do so much better. And that the industry is crying poor is actually a big smoke screen, because if they are allowed to go to a colony cage system, they can then come back to government and say, you allowed us to put in this expensive system and we want 20 to 25 years to phase it out. And so we're stuck with this system, whereas in Europe, they're selling off their cages to Bulgaria. We don't have anywhere to sell these cages to. And if I were in government and someone came to me and said, you're going to cost me millions of dollars, and actually I'm not going to vote for you next time if that's the case, I wouldn't be phasing it out real fast. So I've seen the system. Seriously, I don't see any difference. And this is such a big opportunity for us. We can lead the world instead of dragging along behind.